We stopped in the chola fields, and you know, it's so beautiful out here. It, you know, you forget that this was one of the most deadliest roads ever. Now we're coming up on Bates Well, and all of a sudden, man, look how healthy these plants are. And you can definitely tell that they definitely got water in this area, which would probably be the reason why there's Bates Well, but this is really a healthy desert. I mean, this place is absolutely just beautiful. Let's go in here and chill out. Well, one of the first stops that we're making is Bates Well, because I've seen this in every video. And this was a working cattle ranch. And it's really cool that it's still available. And you're out here in the middle of nowhere. And how awesome is this? Let's see what this is. This is so awesome. This is still here. Isn't this cool? Look at this. How awesome is this, that this is still here? And you can put your hands on the walls and look in here. You know, this is where they lived out his life. How amazing is this, that this place is still here? How awesome is this? Look at these old buildings down here. You know, we're going right down the same trails that the ranchers, you know, use forever. And this is just a really cool, cool place. Look at this old shack right here. It's like where they hit, they're tacked right here. Tell you what, I'm impressed with this. You know, we've got that same windmill at the ranch. It's amazing how Chicago, Illinois, all those basically came out of Chicago, Illinois. Isn't that incredible? Look at this old water tank. This is just beautiful. It's a nice water trough right there. So there's the... they got barbecue grills. They're living. That's where they're living. Cabeza Prieta. Okay, so we're leaving the organ pipe, and then there's the facility where the border patrol are at. Now, one thing about this area, there's been over 500 deaths of people coming through here that didn't make it. So, you know, that's kind of what you get here. You know, you look at the beauty of this place, but you realize when it gets hot that it changes.
Mesquite, you wanna see a variety of mesquite trees,
vines,
and grasses.
Now, where we're at right now is Papago Well, Tule Well. So the Tule Well is 32 miles this way. There is a flag right there showing that there's water here. And then there is the windmill. So here we are, kind of, I'm gonna say somewhere in the half, you know, of where we're gonna be. And then there's these flags right here to show people that there's water. And you know, regardless what your feelings are, man, I've been out, I've had trouble in the desert before, if you've seen some of my videos. And it's pretty incredible that this is here, because I don't care what the situation is, you don't want anybody dying from not having any water. Man, that's got water. And that's pretty cool. That is pretty cool that's out here. It's also cool that there's water. Now, another thing that a lot of people, now what they'll do is they'll take these tires, and they've got them tied together. And what they'll do is they'll drag them behind a Jeep. And then what it does is smooths this out, right? So they can see somebody walking across the road and they can tell that somebody's there. Now, it'll smooth this out just like this. So when you're walking across here, right here, you know, you see a footprint. Now, I'm told that a lot of times what they'll try to do is put carbon on their feet and then walk across that. But if you look at this area right here and you see how it's been done and you see this footprints, I mean, you can still see, if you know what you're looking at, you can still see that the ground's been disturbed, and then they'll know you've shot across this road. I'm sure there's ways around it, but that's a pretty easy way to be able to see that there's been some activity, so they can try to control what's going on out here, because, you know, the reality is the amount of deaths is just unbelievable here. I mean, it really is. The fact that there's no wall, you know, like a wall or not, it keeps people from coming across that are going to die out here, whether, you know, they should be here or not. That's not the decision. The discussion is that people are dying out here because this is treacherous, and they're not qualified to come across here. You know, just like this, a lot of the pioneers that died out here in the late 17s and early 1800s did. So it's a pretty trick setup. You can tell that they've definitely got their wear. And pretty cool. We are coming up on the famous Dave O'Neill grave. Now, Dave died in 1916 from exposure. And he had his two compadres come by, because what happened was his mules ran off and he died on this spot. And they buried him where he died, right here. Here's somebody that didn't make it on the trail right here. 1871. That is correct. I did say the Mesa of Death. We're at a place on the Road of the Devil that I've wanted to come forever. And this is a big, 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 big deal. We're going to go up to the nine tanks. And what we're hoping to do is go to all nine tanks. But there's a petroglyph up here that's supposed to be probably the most important petroglyph in the state of Arizona. Hey, what? We got a hike ahead of us. I don't even know which way to attack that, to be honest with you. So this is just gonna be, and they say 50 feet to the first tank, and that people would be dead at the bottom of this tank. They couldn't get in here. So looky here, we've got a first tank right here. I'm gonna tell you, that's steep as shit. So let's just not even fool ourselves. And we still gotta go up there. And we're only at tank one. You know, we got one tank down. And I'm telling you what, it ain't for the weak of heart. Is another one. So I don't know if you'd count that. I would say you'd count that as a water hole. So I'm gonna go 1, 2, 3. Now, what that means is between 3 and 4, somewhere in here is a crevice that should have a petroglyph we're looking for. Well, here we go. Here's tank number 4. Look down there. See the grinding holes on that rock down there? So they were setting up in here. I'm going to get you down in here. Grinding holes right there. We're going to take a look at number 4. So those glyphs are supposed to be over here somewhere. Nice grinding hole. They did a lot of work up here. This looked pretty interesting though, because it looked like it went back. So I can't imagine coming down this thing, you know, being beat up or even try to get up here. I feel really disappointed, man. It's kind of like I went up the 3 different ways because I'm like, man, the last thing I want to do is come up here and fail, regardless of any mission that we go on, whatever the journey or adventure is, right? But there's a point where you go, okay, there's my point where, you know, I had a worse time getting up wasn't as difficult, but then I'm like, okay, now you got to get down. So how's that going to be? And you're like, damn, wow. And you know, I've never ever gave up on an adventure yet. I have not. And you know what? I think I've come to the point where, you know, I'm not going to go higher than tank 5. So let's make our way down and find that petroglyph in the lower level and take our time and really study this and take our time getting down, because, man, you definitely do not want to fall. Definitely makes you feel a little better. Momentum goes fast on this hill. That's for sure. I don't see anywhere else there could be. You know, if this guy laid on the wall, I just don't know where it could be. Safer. Get under here. See. And if we got to work out, that's fine. But this would be a great place to have put petroglyphs right here. This would be the place. If I was going to see a place where there would be petroglyphs. Oh my God. You got to be kidding me. Oh. Wow. That's got to be it right there. I'm so pumped up. I'm getting a crawl out of here. And you know, there might be pictures. I've never seen pictures of it. And, you know, but I saw a pin there. Somebody's been up here because they had a pin. So how crazy is that? Oh, I had. I'll tell you what. That was too cool. Oh, look at there. Tell me I didn't smash that sucker. Dang. Well, I haven't bled for a while, but it looks like I'm bleeding. That hurt. Oh, this is where the canyon is. It's a mesa of death right there. I'll tell you what. This adventure was unbelievable today. Hidden treasure. So somewhere up in these mountains, in one of the 1,000 caves, is supposedly a wagon full of Winchester rifles. The border, and let's see if we can't find some of this lost treasure that's down here. Wouldn't that be incredible to see the Spanish? Wouldn't it be incredible to see some of the ruins? Wouldn't it be incredible to find a cargo of missing Winchesters? Wow, wouldn't that be incredible? We're gonna walk over to that structure over there just to take a look and see what's over there. And one thing we found was we found caves in that area as well. So we're gonna work this ridgeline now and see what's over there now that we have checked this out. So I'm gonna look at a structure that has smooth rocks that maybe could be a place where there would be a tank over there, because that's where they would have been. They would have been where the water was. That's where they would have been. So we're going to head that way, and I'm going to take these spikes out of the side of my shoe like a dumbass, and we're going to go forward. It's like another world up here. Look at this. You know, regardless of what we find or what we don't find, this has been an unbelievable journey today. Look at this jungle. Craziest stuff I have been through, hands down. Some of it's got to be bad. Just haven't gotten into that yet. Okay, we found petroglyphs. Okay, so here we are. We have found mortars right here. Oh my God, I don't know what the hell's in there. I'm gonna make sure that thing's clear. There we are. Oh my God. Wow. Here we go. Here we go back again. It's crazy. Wow, we found them after all this. You know, I'm gonna get some pictures so I can have Hari do some de-stretch on it. As soon as I'm sure there's nothing in there, I'm gonna crawl back in that. I'm gonna get a hold of John, see if he wants to come this way. Wow, look at this. Oh my God, there it is. There it is. Holy shit. Look at that. Oh my God. There is the cross. 17, like 31, right there. There is the Spanish cross. You have got to be kidding me. Holy smoke. Oh my gosh. Man, how cool is this? I tell you what, again, you can't give up. You can't stop. You got to keep going. You can't ever stop. Here it is. We found the infamous 17, looks like 31 right here. There's the cross. There's the marker there. Oh my gosh. Wow. And there they were. So that shows that they were here. You know, the ancients were here because there's the mortars underneath here. So now we got to check that cave out, and I'm going to dig in there as soon as I catch myself and everything I've got on this, make sure I've got everything. Oh, man. I cannot believe I found this. I cannot believe. Wow. Damn it. I'm so excited. I'm so stoked. It's crazy. It's crazy. Wow. We are in probably one of the most beautiful desert settings. And I'm going to turn you around real quick so you can take a look. Look at that beauty right there. Look at this desert. This desert is unreal. Now, where are we at today? Well, we're right now on a place called Cipriano Pass, which is right outside the Road of the Devil, which is actually, we're heading into the old real Road of the Devil that went on down to Yuma. But I'm telling you what, this is one of the most spectacular deserts that I have ever come across in our travels anywhere. Look at that.